First up on today's show, we have Ben's board games.
Then we have how robots can improve farming with Kanwar.
Finally, to close out the show, we have the latest installment of sports with Lindsay Woods and Alexi Florin.
All that and more on today's episode of Flyer News. Run fast for your mother, run fast for your father, run fast for your sister, never run us. Leave us alone, alone behind. You can't carry it with you if you want to survive. The days are over, the days are done. Can I get a rest? We are late.
Good morning, Flyer News. Today is day 4 with periods running A, C, D, E, F. I'm Kira McCauley.
And I'm Elliot Lord.
Hey, Elliot. Why do you think board games are called board games?
I don't know. Do you have any ideas?
Maybe it's because they're played on a board.
Or maybe it's because people play them when they're bored?
Oh, yeah. That's probably what it is.
Do you like board games?
I'm not sure. Let's hear more about them on Bed's Board Games.
Hey guys, welcome back to Ben's Board Games. Today I will be talking about a game, or rather a series of games, developed by an indie game studio that hit it big. This very beloved series is Exploding Kittens. There have been a lot of variants of this game, and I'm going to be showing you my official tier list. First up is the original, the fan favorite that inspired it all. I'm going to give it an S tier. I don't think it needs an explanation. Next, we have the expansion packs. These added a few cards to the game, attempting to change up the style of play. The first is Imploding Kittens, with the most notable addition being the namesake card that becomes an instant lose when it is drawn for the second time. The catch is that after it is drawn the first time, it will be placed face out for all to see, adding an interesting dynamic, putting this at a solid A tier. Shrieking Kittens, the second expansion, adds some game-breaking cards for experienced players such as the namesake card and Catatomic Bomb. In my opinion, this expansion pack should only be bought by people who are experienced in the game to add some spice to their gameplay. Shrieking Kittens is a bit too chaotic for me, so I'm putting it at a C tier. Barking Kittens is the final expansion, with the Barking Kittens allowing you to directly target other players. Overall, the expansion is a fun add-on, especially with the addition of the Tower of Power, but honestly, isn't super game-changing, so I will put it at a B tier. Zombie Kittens is a variant in which dead players can come back to life each time a defuse is played. This is a super cool addition, creating a lot of interesting scenarios, and leaves players with the option to use a zombie kitten or choose to explode with the hopes of being revived later in the game. The best part of Zombie Kittens is that instead of sitting around and waiting for the game to end, players who have already died can still be involved and are able to play certain cards and be interacted by with live players. Zombie Kittens gets an A tier. The Party Pack allows you to play with up to 10 players, officially allowing me to host a 10-person Exploding Kittens night. S tier! Exploding Minions is essentially the same game as Exploding Kittens, but with an addition of the clone card and new minion-themed artwork. To me, Exploding Minions isn't that good. To me, Exploding Minions isn't worth buying over the original and takes away from the core flavor of the game. Exploding Minions goes in C tier. For just $5 more than the base game, Exploding Kittens, Recipes for Disaster, is a great way to change up your game every round. The premise of the game is that there are 13 different ways to play, shown through recipe booklets specifically designed for certain game experience. If you want to play a 2-minute game, there's a recipe for that. If you want to spy on other players, there's a recipe for that too. Honestly, Recipes for Disaster is the biggest bang for your buck I can imagine, putting it at an S tier. Exploding Kittens Cat Burglar Edition unfortunately does not match the immense value of Recipes for Disaster. The addition to the game is a plush cat burglar that players pass around while stealing cards from other players. While a cute addition, this puts the game up $10 over the base game, and honestly, isn't worth it when I can buy Recipes for Disaster and still have spent $5 less than this. Honestly, this doesn't add much because I can just take any plushier object and use that as a cat burglar. This is a strong D tier. The newest Exploding Kittens game is Exploding Kittens Good vs. Evil. This includes a crazy new card, Armageddon. Good vs. Evil gets an A tier from me. If you enjoy Exploding Kittens, you might want to think about getting one of these variants or an expansion pack. Stay saucy and don't explode, Flyers. Let's take it back to the desk.
Kira, how do you feel about robots?
Robots are kind of scary. They're getting smarter every day.
Do you think they'll take over the world?
I don't know about that. Do you think they will?
I think they'll definitely impact the future in some pretty significant ways.
Yeah. Let's take it to Kanwar, who is going to tell us his info on how robots could make farms more biodiverse with precision crop planting.
Hey guys, I'm Connor Deepsingrandava, and today I'm going to be talking about that robots could make farms more biodiverse with precision crop planting. There are farmers who manually crossbreed plants to make plants more biodiverse. The process is called strip planting, but this takes time and knowledge. But with the help of robots, we can decrease our required knowledge by using smart technologies, which can also decrease the time by using algorithms to make plants biodiverse and maintaining the plants. Robots are equipped with a seed drill that deposits crops in 2-meter wide rows and a combine harvester that collects the plants once they reach maturity. A professional farmer claims, with conventional farm machinery and conventional operational practice, it's very hard to do that. But with these small, very precise autonomous machines, we can now actually maybe divide our fields up differently and start farming in a different geometry, which might be beneficial for crop growth, and also wider biodiversity and carbon capture and all those sort of things. This could enable commercial farms to stop planting vast, non-biodiverse fields and reap the benefits of mingling plants with different needs and mutually beneficial habits. However, he does also claim that this experiment might not be as accurate because of different factors such as pests who might have eaten some of their crops while, or might have missed some of their crops while this experiment was occurring. That's all it for this Flyer News video. My name is Conor Deepsingrandava, and let's take it back to desk.
Go. Mistreatment of animals has always been a problem in our society. So when it's nice, when we get some good news. Recently, two husky pups were adopted from a shelter after being thrown over the fence of said shelter. Both puppies, one male, one female, were severely underweight and things were not looking good. However, after a new diet, they managed to get back their energy. They were adopted into a foster house last Monday, and now they are ready to live a full and happy life.
An animal shelter in the UK rescued a puppy with 6 legs. She was found abandoned in a parking lot. Vets urged the owners to bring forth any information they had. However, no one responded, so the vets decided the best possible course of action would be to begin diagnosing her. They hope she will be able to find a loving home in the future. Do you like sports?
Well, I mean, I don't really know that many sports.
Me neither. Have you ever played any? I definitely have not.
Well, yeah, I used to play soccer, but that was years ago.
So collectively, we don't know that much about sports?
Yep.
Well, luckily for us, we have people who know more about sports than we do. Let's take it to the sports desk. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy. Don't ever play with guns.
Welcome back to Sports Desk Flyers. I'm Alexi Florian.
And I'm Lindsay Wood, and today we'll be covering our Flyers sports for this upcoming week.
Starting off with field hockey, the Flyers beat Weymouth away this past Wednesday 2-0, and they have a game today against Newton South and Wednesday against Newton North. Let's hope they can make it 3 in a row.
Great win for the field hockey team. Moving on to football, the Flyers had an away game this past Saturday against Wellesley and lost 7-26, putting them at 3-2 for the season. The Flyers play Weymouth this Friday at home, hoping to bounce back after the loss.
Moving on to soccer, the boys' soccer team beat Milton this past week 3-0. What a great win. Let's hope they can win another against Weymouth today at 4 p.m. They also have a home game Thursday against Newton North and a game Saturday against St. John's Prep.
Following along is girls' soccer. They had a game last Wednesday against Braintree and won 2-1. The girls have 3 away games this week, today in Weymouth, Thursday at Newton North, and Saturday at Waltham High School. Wish them good luck for their mega games they have this week.
Redirecting to girls swim and dive, they had a meet yesterday against Needham High School, and they have another meet against Brookline on Saturday.
Well, I hope they do well. Volleyball has games today against Weymouth and a game Thursday against Newton North.
Cross country has a meet Wednesday against Newton North High School and Needham High School. Hopefully Framingham can win against those two.
Last but not least, boys golf has a match Wednesday against Newton North High School. Let's pray for Adele.
Geez, there's a lot of Weymouth and Newton North games happening this week.
I know. Hopefully Flyers can come on top for all of them. Well, with that, I'm Lindsay Wood.
And I'm Alexi Flooring in Sports Hour.
That's all we have for today's episode of Flyer News.
You can rewatch this and other broadcasts again on our YouTube channel or on the FEC TV tab on the school's website.
Also, while you're here, don't forget to check us out on Instagram and Facebook at Framingham High Studios.
But don't move just yet. Next up, we have the latest edition of The Early Bird, hosted by Ben DeGroat and Zach Schneider from Flyer News. I'm Kira McCauley.
And I'm Elliot Lord. Have a terrific Tuesday, FHS.
Everybody was kung fu fighting. Those kids were fast as lightning. In fact, it was a little bit frightening. But they fought with expert timing. There were funky Chinamen from funky Chinatown. They were chopping them up. They were chopping them.
How was your weekend?
I had a pretty good weekend.
Good. It was long weekend?
It was the last long weekend of the big three. Three straight long weekends.
That was fun.
It's going to suck next week, though.
Happy Indigenous
It's going to be Monday.
Day.
Oh, yeah. Happy Indigenous People's Day. Important to give a shout out. But, yeah, next Monday, first Monday is going to be pretty
suck
tough.
Day.
Oh, man.
Too?
I don't even want to. I think we're tanking.
Happy,
it's time to tank.
Happy
tank
Mac
for,
Jones sad face day.
For tanking for, who are we tanking for? I don't know.
Caleb Williams, Bo Nix.
There's so many quarterbacks, I think.
The Washington guy, Penix, whatever
his name is. He could be really good.
Yeah.
I think we tank for him. I think he could, maybe he'll save the franchise.
Yeah.
Maybe, Zach, maybe we need a new coach. I don't even know. But I don't
maybe
know. I think
to, maybe, what
they'll
I have
keep
to do.
Bill.
Maybe we need to
I think
root for a
Bill.
New team.
That's actually not that,
that
bad.
Might, that might
I think
be a good
I think
idea.
Maybe we root for the Dolphins. They dropped 70.
Dolphins. I can't root for someone in the same division. We'll think about it.
We'll think
while we think
it.
About it. Let's roll that intro. Super Brought to Flyers, welcome back to The Early Bird. I'm Zach Schneider, and with me, as always, is the man, Mr. Benjamina DeGroat.
Benjamina?
Yeah, Zach? Yeah, you call me Thanks. Zacharino. Or
Zacharino,
whatever.
Yeah, but you didn't have to make it Benjamina. That's, like, weird.
I think I've tried that before.
I don't know about that. I don't know about
No.
I don't think so. I don't think that's
said,
I have many nicknames, but definitely not.
Stuff.
Definitely not that. What?
I know all your nicknames, but you said that you had a good weekend watch Patriots. Did you get any homework done, or did you not have any, or what?
I honestly, Zach, I did not have any homework.
You did not have any.
I had, like,
My teachers are probably watching this and thinking like, oh, you had so much homework. What are you even talking about?
Yeah.
I don't remember having any homework, so I didn't have any homework, so I didn't do any homework.
Oh,
so.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
I feel like that's going to set you up for a pretty homework-filled week.
No, because I didn't have
anything.
You're
going to get your work done.
Yeah, I do it in class.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry about it at home.
Yeah.
But, you know, so sometimes there are days when I can't get it all done in class. Got to do it at home.
Yep.
Got to do some homework. Homework, you know, it's just part of life.
Part of life.
You know, something you just gotta gotta do. It kind of stinks, but every day is a homework day.
Yeah.
Except for me.
The weekends for you.
Yeah. How about you, Zach? How's your homework?
You know, I did some this weekend. I don't have a lot. I didn't have a lot due today, but I have a lot due on Thursday. So I got a head start. I'll get a head start tonight as well too.
Very smart.
I learned from our friend Mikey over here, who actually had a PSA about getting your homework done.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
let's check it out.
Wow, Minecraft is so much fun to play with, especially in a friend group right now, right here, with my friend right here.
Yep.
Oh, wow, look at the time. I think I have to go. I will see you later.
I will see you. Maybe we're not in the same school.
Oh, yes, indeed. I shall see you later, as in... I will make up a meeting date, and we shall go to that place at that time. I shall see you later. I have to go now.
Hello.
Alright, I'm bored. I had enough of Minecraft. Let's play Five Nights at Freddy's. Oh boy. I sure do love how long it takes to load. My favorite part of this game is that you have to always use audio cues. You have to listen real closely. Wowza geez, that was sure scary. Oh boy. Oh no! It's dark outside. I surely do hope I don't have any homework. I gotta get this done. Yeah, I think this is good enough.
Thank you very much, Mikey, and a shout out to Kevin for being in that PSA.
Yeah.
He did a great job. He doesn't even go to the school, Zach, and he still helped out. Great job by him. And guys, don't procrastinate your homework. Keep it going so you can have.
You know a thing or two about that.
Yeah. I don't procrastinate. Well, I do procrastinate, but I learned a thing or two from Mikey. And do your homework so you have time for cool clubs like the ones in these announcements. In the
older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze, country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Anaya. Those weren't the announcements, actually.
Yeah, sorry for that. I'd like to apologize for the mistake I made
it's all right.
10 seconds ago. But
we all forgive you.
Yeah, thank you, Zach. That's what it's all about.
Thank you
it's important to forgive
thank
people.
Thank you for acknowledging your mistakes. But now we do actually have to send it to announcements.
I'm high on believing. Good morning, Flyers. After school today, Writers Club is having its second meeting. Today will be one of our very important meetings since we will be voting on the theme of our anthology. If you're a member and you can't come, make sure to email me and let me know so I can tell you what you missed. The meeting's going to be in F208 right after school. Can't wait to see you there.
Hello, my name is Lucas Poole, and I play Henry Antrobus.
Hi, I'm Maddie Tessitore, and I'm playing Gladys Antrobus.
And if you like woolly mammoths, dinosaurs, the Ice Age, big old floods, and potatoes, then...
You should come see The Skin of Our Teeth on the 13th and 14th at 7 p.m. at the auditorium. You can get your tickets at showticksforyou.com or at the door when you come.
Thank you.
Some great announcements. What, we had two? We had two?
Lovely Tuesday we're having, isn't it? Sorry.
Is that
I don't know. I was just thinking Tuesday and like Tuesday with a CH, like Tuesday, like British.
What made you think of that? Any announcements?
I don't really know. No, just my mind. I was just feeling British for
unique,
a second.
Unique.
Yeah.
Good creativity.
Thank you, Zach.
You know, we heard about the play coming up.
Yeah.
I think there hasn't been a lot of coverage on that, so I think that's important.
I think we're having them on Friday.
We are having them on
Friday for an interview.
Are you going to go?
Am I going to go? I might go. I'm not sure. I am busy Friday and Saturday night, so I'm not sure if I can.
I'll have to see if I can make it.
I hope to. I hope to. I hope to get there on time.
A good production.
You know, get there before 7 p.m. because the early bird gets the worm.